everyone, I'm Simon Mayer. I'm from Sheffield in England, which is a big industrial city in the north of England, or at least it used to be when I was a child. A lot of the industry has disappeared now, but it's still a very big city. I first became aware of the mandolin when I was very young, probably before the age of 10. And we used to go across to my cousin's house, and my cousin was a little bit older than me. He was already a very good guitarist, and probably still is. I haven't seen him for many years. But there was a mandolin kicking about the house. I never saw anybody play it, but I became aware of it then. Then a few years later, when I was in my teens, my best friend from school introduced me to a record, vinyl in those days, called Rags, Reels and Airs, which was by a musician called Dave Swarbrick, who sadly is no longer with us. Swarb, as he was known, played the mandolin and the fiddle in equal measures and with equal dexterity. And he was a traditional musician. He was English, but his style was, I suppose, more Scottish than anything else. And this record of traditional music that he put out, Rags, Reels and Airs, really sparked an interest in me, and I decided to take up the fiddle and the mandolin at the same time when I was probably about 16 or 17, something like that. I'd already been playing the guitar for a few years, but not to any high standard. And that's how I got started. And later I heard people playing classical music on the mandolin, and that broadened my interest. And I now play, well, that's a long time ago now. I now play with Hilary James, my longtime partner, and I play in a quartet called the Mandolinquents, which is primarily two mandolins, classical guitar, and Hilary plays the bass mandolin and sings. And I've got various other projects as well. I play in a kind of country western swingy group called Slim Panatella and the Mellow Virginians. And I also play in the Simon Mayer Quartet, which is again with Hilary and with two young musicians. Good to have some young blood, Florence Petit, the cellist, and Elias Sibley on guitar. So lots of things going on at the moment. Playing professionally now since, oh goodness me, 1976, a long time ago. And it's strange in that time what you end up doing and how you make a living. There's probably no such thing as a rich mandolin player, but just occasionally interesting things have happened. Hilary James and I recorded an album called Lullabies with Mandolins in 2006, I think it was, and it was exactly what you might think from the title. It was a mixture of songs and gentle classical pieces that I'd arranged for mandolin quartet, and we put it out as a labour of love, really. But one track off it, which was written by the Norwegian composer Edvard Grieg, I think it was just a little piano piece that I rearranged for mandolin quartet, has ended up being a bit of a minor hit on iTunes and kept us going during the lockdown years, during COVID, which was great. And then we got a very strange phone call one day from Los Angeles. Do we own the rights to a song called Gobble Gobble Gobble? Now, Gobble 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 was a song that Hilary and I wrote. It would have been in the 1980s, and it's a song about a turkey. We wrote it for children, and it was just a little throwaway thing, but we put it out on an album of children's music that we did then. And then we pretty much forgot about it. And suddenly we get a phone call from a music sourcing agency in Los Angeles wanting to know if we own all the rights for it, because the Simpsons want to use it. And they used it for a 8-week trailer for the new series of The Simpsons, and that was about 3 or 4 years ago. So it's little things like that that crop up, and of course we're constantly doing concerts, and I teach mandolin, not privately, but I do probably about 3 or 4 mandolin workshops. Actually, it's more like 4 or 5 these days, every year, and they're increasingly popular. And we form an impromptu mandolin orchestra for a weekend. I do some in the north of England, some in the south, and they're really proving very popular. And as I speak, which is in March 2003, we're going to Canada, which is will be the first time for how long? I think it was 11 years ago we were last in Canada, so we're really looking forward to that. We're going to play at Goderich Festival. That's just me and Hilary James. And what else am I looking forward to? September. September is a red letter day in the diary, because I get to play 2 nights at Wembley Arena, which are already sold out. Now, Wembley Arena is a 12,500 seater, so I'll be playing to 25,000 people over the course of 2 days as soloist with the BBC Concert Orchestra, and we're going to be playing some music by from Studio Ghibli films, some Japanese film music, which is really lovely. Actually, I've been playing through the part just these last few days, so I'm really looking forward to that. I think it'll probably be the biggest audience that I've ever played to. My most recent album, which is just out, came out a couple of weeks ago, is all the music of Turlough O'Carolan, the Irish composer who was around in the late 1700s and early 1800s, and I've done some heavy arranging of his tunes, and that seems to be getting good reviews and selling well as I speak, so I'm very excited to see how that is going to be going. And we've been performing music from the album with the Simon Mayer Quartet. Now, Fabio, when he asked me to record this video, asked me what I like to play when I'm not on stage, when I'm just sat in my front room noodling about on the mandolin. Well, we all noodle, don't we? And actually, I drive Hilary mad because I noodle while we're watching the telly. She keeps telling me to shut up. But I'm very fond of doing little arrangements of songs from my childhood, old children's songs that I remember. And there's one which, if you weren't born in the United Kingdom, you probably won't be aware of it, but it's called Nelly the Elephant, and it's a lovely little tale about an elephant who ran away from the circus. I'm not going to sing it for you, but I'll play you the tune as I noodle it on the mandolin while I'm watching telly. So that's the kind of thing that I play when I'm just sat in my front room. I think I have occasionally played that on stage, actually, but it's a throwaway little piece. Why do I find that difficult to say? When I'm on stage, what do I play on stage? I love lots of things. I like playing arrangements of classical music. I don't actually play that much music that's been written for the mandolin. Although I did do Vivaldi's Concerto a couple of years ago, just after lockdown, with the London Mozart Players, which was a real thrill playing with top classical musicians. And I do various bits of Kalacha and a little bit of Beethoven. I love playing traditional music, and I love playing bits of swing, bits of jazzier stuff. But I suppose primarily the fields that I operate in are a kind of classical and traditional music. But I don't only enjoy playing the mandolin, although I suppose most people who have heard of me know of me as a mandolin player. But I've been playing the fiddle as long as I've been playing the mandolin, and I love playing the fiddle as well. I'm playing more and more of it in concerts and the guitar. And the big thrill at the moment is that we're doing lots of my own compositions and my own arrangements on stage with the Simon Mayer Quartet that we've recently started. So it's great hearing the fruits of my labours when I'm sat at a computer doing some arranging or some composing come to life on stage. So that's what's happening at the moment.